Hi, everybody, and welcome to a brand new week of Houston Life. I'm Derek Shore.
And I'm Jennifer Broom. Happy Monday. You know, when it comes to fashion, it is never one size fits all.
That is so true. And no matter what your shape is, you shouldn't settle for fashion that is not flattering. So image and brand consultant Natalie Weekly is here to help us dress for our body types.
Natalie in the house.
Hi,
welcome back to the show.
Thank you so much for having me. I appreciate it.
So first of all, we've heard of different body shapes, like triangle, square. Explain what this actually means.
Okay, great. So we're basically talking about the measurements of your shoulders, bust, waist, and hip, and how that translates to your shape. And there are five main shapes.
Okay.
You've got rectangle, hourglass, oval, triangle, and inverted triangle. We have a couple of variations within that, but those are the shapes, and that gives us an idea of how to dress you and best way to flatter your body.
Okay, so let's start with the rectangle.
Okay, let's do it. I'm going to draw you a little, obviously you know what a rectangle looks like.
Okay, so it's a rectangle the long way. And by the way, we should point out that there is no wrong body shape.
No, there is not.
So you shouldn't feel bad about the type of body. You just want to make sure you're dressing appropriately, right?
Yes, not at all. And there are so many trends out there, and some of them look great on some body styles, and some of them do not.
So this could also be, though, like the athletic body type, the boyish body type.
Exactly right. This is the athletic body type. This is the type that you really don't see a lot of variation between the shoulders and the hips, where the waist is just a little bit wider. I generally fall into this category.
Are these typically like the super slim people?
You know what? Yes, but not always. A rectangle, it really can happen at any size. You don't have to feel like, oh, well, I'm not a size 2, so I'm not a rectangle. You could definitely be a rectangle and just be a size 16.
Okay, so if shoulders and hips then are generally about the same width, then you might be a rectangle. In fact, some celebrities, if you like to look at celebrity stuff online or Instagram.
Who doesn't like to look at celebrity stuff?
So we have a photo right there.
Is that Kate Hudson? Love her. Love her.
So she is a rectangle, and you can see there's just not a whole lot of definition with her waist. You've got shoulders that are about the same width as the hip, and we can play around with that. You can do a lot of different styles, a lot of different shapes, and that will help flatter, like we said, flatter the body. Generally, the eye is sort of going for a balanced body, which the balance is this triangle up here and this triangle here. So hourglass is considered the fully balanced, which we'll talk about in a minute. But when we are styling, we're generally going for that.
Trying to create that illusion.
Exactly.
Okay, so let's bring out our first model. We have Stephanie.
Woo-hoo.
I think this is someone you might recognize.
Yeah, you might recognize her.
So Natalie, tell us what you put Stephanie in and why.
Okay, so I've done a couple of things. So first of all, like we said, Stephanie is a rectangle, and you can kind of see how her shoulders and her hips are about the same width. There's not a whole lot of definition with her waist here. So we've done a couple of things. One, we're working with some trends that are happening right now, the fit and flare, also the gathered waist. So we're creating a waist for her and giving that illusion of a hip.
Go a little bit more with that, kind of the poofier skirt.
Yes.
Really helps to give you.
Which is very on trend right now, and you can do a lot with that. So you can do that. Another option she might have is if you did a really dramatic sleeve, whether it's a poofy sleeve or epaulettes on your jacket, or if you have a very structured jacket. You just want to make sure that you're always then bringing it in at the waist.
Well, Natalie, let me ask you that. Are there things that should be avoided? Because what if you wanted to wear just a very sleek sort of like pencil design skirt? Is that something, if you have a rectangular body shape, you should avoid?
You can. You don't have to avoid it. Here's the cool thing about knowing all of these rules is when you know them, then you can break them. And you know why you're breaking them, and you can break them well.
Okay.
So break them with purpose, with intention. So if we are, in this case, we're creating the balance because we're coming in at the waist and we're going out again at the hip. And if she decided, oh, well, I really want to wear a shift dress or just like you said, that straight style, she knows, oh, well, I've got a rectangular body. That's great. Maybe you can accent it with a necklace.
Maybe add a belt.
Maybe you could add a belt, or you could do something to mix it up, or just leave it straight and decide today I'm going to look long and lean.
Okay. Stephanie, we'll let you go.
Thank you so much.
Nice work modeling. Let's talk about the hourglass shape. You just drew a smaller hourglass, but talk about how we define the hourglass and what we should look for.
Okay, so for the hourglass, I love that I have this little thing here, by the way. Thanks.
We're back in school.
This is great. Totally. Okay, so everyone look here. No, hourglass is just like what it sounds like. It's an hourglass where you've got your shoulders and your hips are roughly the same size. If you are measuring yourself, you want to make sure that your waist has about 10 inches difference between your shoulders and your waist, and then 10 inches between your waist and your hips. So it is a very defined
curve. This is a smaller waisted
person.
with broader shoulders and maybe broader hips.
Exactly. This person is well acquainted with their tailor because they always have to go in and have things altered. Usually,
there's a photo of Sofia Vergara, by the way, on the screen.
Yes, which is a classic hourglass shape. And like
it's kind of that classic old Hollywood shape, you know, the Hollywood starlet shape.
And there are two different kinds of hourglasses. There's what we call the neat hourglass and then a curvy hourglass. So we were talking about sizes. It's not a particular size. It's just the way that your body is shaped. So neat would be, or curvy would be, as you would expect, just a more curvy version. And then neat would be just a little bit trimmer.
Let's bring out our model, Michelle, to see what kind of clothing works well on an hourglass figure.
Come on out. Yay.
Michelle, looking very nice.
Hey, this is Michelle. So we've done a couple of things. First of all, as you can see, we've got our shoulders and our hips are about in line. And she's got a fairly defined waist. And then we threw a belt on it as well to make it more accentuated, which you can, or you can leave it without. Like I said, the hourglass is already fairly balanced. So you don't have to do a lot to create that balanced, flattering shape. But you can.
Should the hourglass always try to accentuate the waist?
They really should. Generally speaking, the very boxy tops that are in right now are really going to be a no-go. They're not going to be the most flattering.
Even if you tuck it in and do so, you
so that is what you can do, and that's what I said about you know the rule, then you can break it. We actually, when we were shopping for this, we found a great baggy sweater for her, and we did it oversized, which generally would be a rule that you would avoid for an hourglass.
Did you put a belt on it though?
We did not put a belt on it, but because it was oversized, it sort of fell in at the waist anyway. So you can work within this, but you just visually want to make sure that you're always going for the balance.
Because with this body type, anything that's oversized, boxy is going to make you look
heavier.
Bigger than you are.
Absolutely. That's the best part about following these rules when you do decide you want to. It easily adds 7 to 10 pounds if you're not following those rules, which who wants that?
Yeah. So always remember to accentuate the waist.
Michelle, thank you so much. Let's move on to our next body shape, which is the oval.
Okay. So oval is the great part about these shapes. They are pretty self-explanatory, which I love. The oval is what you would expect, where this is a person who carries their weight a little bit more in the middle, where the shoulders and the hips maybe match, but the waist measurement is going to be just a little bit wider. And that has, each body shape has its own challenges. I mentioned that the hourglass is well acquainted with their tailor, because they're always having to bring things in. The oval needs to make sure that the waist is a little bit higher.
So going more for that empire waist look?
Absolutely.
Okay. And if you watch NBC Channel 2, Prime Time, there's Mandy Moore. You watch her on This Is Us. She is an example of an oval-shaped body.
She is, and this is a great example. We tend to think oval is always larger, and that's not always the case. It can be the full gamut with all of these shapes. It can be the full gamut of sizes. So, I'm excited to show you that one.
Okay, let's see our model. I think it's Beverly.
Beverly?
Right?
It is.
Woohoo! Ooh, I love the colors in this.
Very nice. Beverly.
Okay, so this is our classic oval, where you can see her hips and her shoulders are aligned, and we have just a little bit more width here in the waist. So we've done a couple of things here. One, you can never go wrong with something that's elongating. Maxi dresses are a great style, and so we've got the great elongating of the maxi dress.
Well, maxi dresses are so perfect for the climate here.
Yes, they are. I'm like, come on. By the way,
explore
the space. We're gonna dance together. So as we talk about this oval shape, y'all, this is my mom, everyone.
Oh,
that's
so nice. Okay. So much. Why is she dancing?
I'm so related. This is real trust when your mom lets you dress her.
Yeah.
We've also done a cropped cardigan, and the cropped cardigan. Now listen. I know that they have a lot of stuff out there for ovals that is very long, and that is very dangerous, because if you do that, you just need to make sure that you're somehow still creating a waist in some way. Generally, that's gonna be with an empire waist, which is what we've done here. And don't forget the value of a good print and pattern. Here, the print and pattern puts all the attention below the waist and up above, as we've also done some fun tassel earrings that are also on trend as well.
Beverly.
So think about all those ways.
You look great.
You look awesome. Fancy.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, we got just a couple minutes left.
Let's move on to triangle.
Oh, yes. Triangle. So triangle is a person that carries their defined section on their shoulders, where they've got a fairly straight waist and hips, but they've got a little bit broader.
You're going inverted triangle on me already.
I am going inverted triangle on you. Sorry.
Back up, sister. Back up one.
Let's just keep going. Thanks. By triangle, I mean actual triangle.
Okay. So does this mean very narrow shoulders but broader hips?
Exactly. See how well we've discussed it already.
By the way, Beyonce is an example of a triangle body shape. I think we have a photo of her.
Definitely. Definitely. We're, as you can see, very defined waist, but definitely carrying more in the hips and back than in the shoulders.
Okay. Tammy, our model, is going to show us how you dressed her. So Tammy, come on out.
Yay! So accentuating the waist again.
Absolutely. Always remembering that waist. So Tammy is a triangle. As you can see, her shoulders and waist are a bit smaller than her hips. And this is one of the more common body shapes. Ladies, we are designed to have hips. It's okay that you have hips. So here's what we've done. We've done the off-the-shoulder trend.
Just so hot right now.
Huge right now and wonderful for summer. And we've done a huge ruffle here, which really balances out the hip. So it actually makes the hip look smaller because the ruffle goes past
the hips.
And then we also have, again, the empire waist pulling in there. Actually, not as much of an empire, but still pulling in at the waist. This is a great example as well of a pattern that's very flattering because this bold line goes just inside of her body line. So that automatically looks a bit more.
The illusion it's creating.
It's all about the illusion.
Oh, so cool.
Good. Tammy, meet us for cocktails after the show. Thank you so much. Well, let's go ahead and bring out our last model, Jordan.
Yes.
We've already
I've already drawn the inverted triangle.
So Jordan is an inverted triangle.
Yes. So inverted triangle, as I mentioned, you're going to see more of the structure here at the shoulder. It's going to come in at the waist and then be a little bit more straight on the hip.
And if you're wondering, like, what kind of celeb, you want to thank Cindy Crawford.
Yes.
For this one.
Absolutely, where you've got that definition. So a couple things that you can do here. Shirt dresses are coming back. Yay, they're some of my favorites. So with this shirt dress, we have, again, always defining that waist when possible, but we've added a whole bunch of stuff down here. We've got the print, we've got some ruffles, we've got some visual interest that
we've got some flow going on.
So it balances her out nicely. So we're going right back to that hourglass shape where we've got shoulders defined, comes in at the waist, and then goes back out. And you can do a lot of things with an inverted triangle. You can, again, do some of those baggy outfits. You can do straight. You can do a ton of stuff.
Jordan, you look fantastic. Thank you so much. And Natalie, we're not done with you. Thank you for all of that. But later on in the show, you're going to tell us about the psychology behind the colors we choose to wear. So stick around.
Stick around.